Bill said my wife thinks she's in the cavalry. Oh. Every time she walks into department store, she yells, blank.
Oh, terrific. I like those like that.
Jackie Texier. Interesting name you got. Texier.
That's right.
Bill said my wife thinks she's in the cavalry. Every time she walks into department store, she yells,
charge.
What? Charge. What did Theodore Roosevelt say at San Juan Hill?
Charge!
Charge! What did the Marines say at Iwo Jima?
Charge!
Charge! What did the doughboy say?
World War I.
At Psalm.
Charge!
Say to me, what did the English Tommy say at Dunkirk, sir?
Yes. What did the English Tommy say at Dunkirk?
Give up.
Charge.
Charge! She's up to five. Now, Jackie, you have to cross your fingers here with this one, because the spell may be broken by now.
I could phrase it for her.
Yes.
What did Dr. Frankenstein give the monster to make him come alive?
Charge!
Oh, you got it! By Jove!
Very good.
Well, Scott Livingston, you got to go to work here now. Think carefully, listen to the question, and study your friends over here and try to match them. 102-year-old Henrietta said, ha, ha, ha. I never should have married old man Periwinkle. Never. At our wedding, he said, I do. He said, I do. But on our honeymoon, he said, I blank.
You know, Mrs. Periwinkle, she's so cranky, isn't
wow,
she?
She's mean.
She's mean as a snake and twice as cranky.
102-year-old Henrietta said, I never should have married old man Periwinkle. At our wedding, he said, I do. But on our honeymoon, he said, I
can't.
I can't. That was most amusing. Now, everyone has to say, I can't. Over here, Scott, to keep you in the game. Okay, Ron.
I can't.
I can't. There's one. Brett. Ron. Oh, you're going to...
This is sort of a match.
It's
not an exact match, but I think the judges will agree that it's a match of sorts. I wish I could.
I wish I could.
That's a match.
Okay. Score is now 6-2. Charles.
He's giving me the vapors. He's been so mean to me tonight.
What do you say, Chuck?
Simply and with dignity, the correct answer.
I can't. Score is now 6-3. Old Mrs. Henrietta said, never should have married old man Periwinkle. At our wedding, he said, I do, but on our honeymoon, he said, I...
can't.
I can't. Richard, what do you say to this?
Can't.
Uh-huh. And you, my dear? Huh. High score. Well, we'll tell you what happens when you get a tie right after we tell you about this.
Today we're going to see how a customer order turns into their perfect PC.
Of a tie. We don't have time to play our regular tiebreaker, so what we're going to do is play sudden death. And the first one of you to score a match will be the winner. We have one tie-breaking question for both of you here. And you'll be playing with our three regulars, Brett, Charles, and Richard. And the two of you will write your answers, and we'll get verbal responses from them. You ready? Good luck to both of you. Here it is. Blank lotion. L-O-T-I-O-N. Blank lotion. All right. Now come over here and start calling on our regulars. Okay, here it is, Brett. Blank lotion.
Body lotion.
Body lotion. No, neither one of them has body lotion.
I have a lot of others.
Yeah, you only get one shot at it, though.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Charles?
quietly and in a dignified manner as befitting nighttime television.
Yes.
Hand lotion.
Hand lotion. Yay! Jackie, come here. Scott, what did you have here? It's suntan lotion. That was a very good answer. Come on down, Jackie. Okay. And I'll get to you in a moment to say goodbye to Scott Livingston. There'll be some gifts for you. Many thanks for being with us at Match Game PM, Scott Livingston. Now, you could win a great deal of money here. We're going to have two audience matches for it. I want to point out that whatever you win in the audience matches, you'll have a chance to multiply by 10. That'll be the final dollar figure you're playing for. We polled a recent studio audience, got their best response to this. Caesar Blank. You get $500 if you match their most popular answer, $250 for the second most popular, and $100 for the third, and three of our six celebrities are permitted to assist.
Okay. Richard Dawson.
Caesar Salad. Yeah!
Caesar Salad is one.
Charles Nelson.
Caesar and Cleopatra.
Caesar and Cleopatra. You got two.
Patty.
Which one?
What do you
one?
Say? Patty Duke-Astor?
Patty Duke-Astor.
All right.
Romero.
Caesar Romero. So those are the three. Caesar Romero, Caesar Salad, and Caesar and Cleopatra. You may choose one of those. You may have a better idea. What would you like to do here?
I'll go with Caesar and Cleopatra.
Okay, that was Charles' answer. We'll find out if it's up there and if so, where. Let's begin at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Caesar's Palace. Okay, we're looking for Caesar and Cleopatra, though. We need a team here. May we see the $250 number? Caesar Romero. That may be a good sign that the big one will be up there. Let's find out right now. Slide it, Earl. Caesar Salad. Oh, see, you didn't win anything there, but you still got another chance. Now, do not be disheartened. We're going to see how you do with your second audio match. Okay, slide it, Earl. The Devil Blank. The Devil Blank.
Richard?
The Devil Salad. No, the the Devil Made Me Do It.
Brett? The Devil and Miss Jones.
Okay.
And Patty again.
Aston?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Okay, May Care. The Devil May Care.
Devil May Care. The Devil May Care. The Devil to Miss Jones. The Devil May Care. The Devil Made Me Do It. Now, have you got another one? Or do you want to pick one of those three? It's up to you entirely now.
I think I'll go with The Devil and Miss Jones.
The Devil and Miss Jones. All right, let's see if we've got it that up there. May we see the $100 response? The Devil and the Deep Blue Sea is a famous popular song of yesteryear, my dear. You're too young to remember it. May we see the $250 number? The Devil and Miss Jones, congratulations. And you won the $250. We multiply that by 10, and you're going to be playing for $2,500. Before we go on there, may we see the top one, please? The Devil Made Me Do It. That's a very popular phrase on television. Okay, Jackie, now to win the $2,500 here, you've got to match one celebrity exactly. You got to choose one now.
Richard.
Okay, Richard.
We'd be playing for $10,000 if you'd taken my word for these little things.
Now you know. Let's stand on the tape right there. Okay, here we go. This is still worth $2,500.
Well, that's not the point.
Here it is now. Good luck to you, my dear. Blank puppy. Blank puppy. P-U-P-P-Y.
Little puppy.
Little puppy. All right, that's what you said. We'll match you for $2,500. Richard, what do you say to that?
Hush.
Hush puppy. Oh. Listen, you've got a grand total of $250, and it's been a pleasure meeting you, my dear. Now, we'll be back in a moment or so. Don't go away.
We give you the answers. You get all night to study. All you have to do is stay awake. Cram tonight at 11, only on Game Show Network.
You snooze, you lose.
Ah. What's it like to crunch a two or two eggs? Creamy, creamy, chewy. Once you crunch it, cookie. Crunchy. Twigs.
It's all in the mix.
Bye, bye, Miss American Pie. Drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry.
And good old boys were drinking whiskey and rye, singing, this'll be the day that I die.
What? I love that song.
Until the very end, we'll be there.
Hello, everything looks wonderful. Oh, I didn't forget about you, sweetie.
Hey, great party.
George, how are you?
Good. Hi.
Hello.
Michael, I...
Your dog has very sophisticated taste.
Thank you.
Caesar, sophisticated food for sophisticated dogs.
Mama keeps whites bright like the sunshine. Mama's got the magical Clorox bleach.
Clorox bleach gets these stains off whites because it doubles the stain removing power of your detergent.
Mama's got the magical Clorox bleach.
Get out of bed and get into Burger King. Start your day with a hot and delicious croissant sandwich for just 99 cents. Sizzling sausage, melted cheese, and egg on a flaky croissant. Just 99 cents for a limited time.
Prepare yourself for a lush, lathery, skin-quenching shower. The line of Dove all-day moisturizing body washes.
What price friendship? Kennedy has the answer on Friend or Foe next. Then the going gets tougher when Russian Roulette opens its doors, followed by Cram.
Gene Rayburn here, goodbye.
Some contestants will receive the new Embermatic Gas Grill by ARPA. It gives you that great flavor of outdoor cooking without the mess and fuss of charcoal. And Armstrong's for...
Win Tuition, the game that turns knowledge into college, now turns your screen into green. Win Tuition is interactive. Register at gameshownetwork.com, and before the show starts, tune in to Win Tuition. Click on the Win Tuition interactive logo, and before you know it, you're back in school. Play along with the show and compete for prizes against other home players. Break for recess and chat with other viewers as you keep track of the competition on live leaderboards. For rules and registration, go to gameshownetwork.com.
Engine Bardol, run with us. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game PM, a Mark Goodson, Bill Cartman production.
On the scene.
Pigeon spits out his silver spoon.
I think the music was kind of my way of rebelling towards it all.
Plus, Willie Ames gets a new wardrobe.
I'm early morning.
The tights come off, Willie slips into an unsung role. In rare moments alone, he retreats to God willing.
That's why they call me Bible Man.
When you hear silver spoons, you think Schroeder, Bateman, Alfonso, and this guy.
This is Freddie, Rick's vice president.
Oh, you can call me Veep.
Porky Pigeon played Freddie Lippin Cottleman, the wise-cracking, tap-dancing dork on this classic 80s sitcom.
Hot babes at 2 o'clock. Darn, it's 3:30. We missed them.
Like many kid stars, Corky cut his teeth on commercials before moving on to bit parts in cheesy 80s slasher flicks like The Forest. His big break came in 1983 when he signed on with Silver Spoons. Four-Eyed Freddy injected new life into the show, and Corky quickly became a fan favorite, getting more love than the Ricker himself.
Hi, Freddy!
He was even the first Spooner to get the call from Johnny.
Would you welcome Corky Pigeon? Corky! You expect to get married someday?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh,
my God. Why does that appeal to you?
But when Silver Spoons was canceled in 1986, it was back to B-movies for Corky. After landing a role as the token geek in Party Camp, Corky's phone stopped ringing. So where is Corky Pigeon now? Corky's ditched the geek chic for a life in rock and roll.
I was on the rebound from the acting, but it was great. I'm like, this is awesome. I'm a rock star. I'm in a band. I think the music was kind of my way of rebelling towards it all.
In 1990, Corky formed The Game, a loud and fast power pop band in L.A.
We went on to make mini records and tour the, you know, country probably a dozen times. And we played with bands like Blink-182.
After The Game split in 1999, Corky stuck with the Skins, playing drums with bands like Big in Japan and The Plastics. Making the jump to music was an easy one for the former Silver Spooner. Going from TV star to average Joe wasn't as smooth.
When you have everything handed to you on a silver platter and everybody loves you and everybody wants you, when that all ends, it's a little shock to your system.
Corky was lucky. He got a lot of support from his mom and his wife, Bobby.
My marriage is the number one priority in my life. She's stuck by my side for the last 12 and a half years through thick and thin, and I know she'll always be there for me.
These days, life isn't all sound checks and recording sessions. Even punk rockers need a hobby.
Let's go golfing.
My life is different now. When I was in the spotlight, I had people asking me for my autograph every day. That doesn't happen so much anymore. But I wouldn't mind being, you know, in the spotlight again, sure. That'd be great.
Now that Freddy lives on in syndication, Corky gets a kick out of seeing his geeky alter ego.
I can't believe that's me, that dorky dude there with the glasses. I mean, I laugh. It's hilarious. It's so far-fetched from what I am now. You know, I'm in a band, I'm a rocker.
And that means Corky's always looking for a gig.
Any A-list bands that would like, you know, a tour drummer, I'm definitely available.
Coming up, rerun hits bottom.
We all play bombs, so we're trying to steal things from each other. It's big comedy.
Next on Where Are They Now? Kid Stars.